If your RV's propane refrigerator works when plugged into AC power, but is not cooling when you switch to propane, and your check light may be on, we'll troubleshoot 10 possible problems. Check battery voltage and gas at the appliance. Make sure the fridge is level. Clean your electrical connections. Listen for the solenoid to open. Check your spark gap. Clean and test the thermocouple. Clean the igniter, burner tube, and jet, plus how to replace the circuit board or thermistor, how to test and adjust your gas pressure, and some operating tips. This is a Dometic 2811 two-way fridge in our 1994 camper. Norcold and other propane electric RV fridges are also absorption types that work in a similar way. Off-grid home propane refrigerators are simpler and do not use any electricity. Be sure the fridge has at least 12 volts of battery power, which powers the controls, opens the solenoid, and creates a spark. Normally, with DC voltage, negative wires are black and positives are red, like on these electrical testers. But in RVs, usually all DC negative wires are white, and positives are different colors for each circuit. Here, negative is white and the fridge positive is blue. Make sure you have propane in the tank and it is turned on. Then light another propane appliance, like the stove, to flush air out of the lines, especially if the propane was turned off. Also, check the shutoff valve at the fridge, which should already be open unless you've closed it. The fridge needs to be fairly level, up to 2 degrees off side to side of the fridge and up to 4 degrees off front to back, but more than that can damage the fridge and it likely won't work. If you have electrical power available, plug the RV into 120 volts AC and turn on the fridge. In about 10 minutes, feel the vent pipe. You should feel heat from the element. With a three-way fridge, test the 12-volt element the same way. Remove the wind covers so you can see the burner. Now unplug the AC power, or push the button on the display panel that switches to gas, and the fridge should switch over to propane. You should hear the clunk of the solenoid valve opening, the igniter sparking, and the flame should light. If the igniter spark keeps ticking, it could be air in the lines. Give it a minute and see if the flame lights. If the flame lights, give it time. It can take over an hour to start cooling the fridge. See description for links to thermometers, fans, and other parts. If you don't see or hear a spark, check and adjust the gap to 1/8 to 3/16 inches from the spark electrode on the igniter to the burner tube. Another possibility is that a bad electrical connection can cause the solenoid, thermocouple, or igniter not to work. Unplug the 120 volt power so you don't get shocked. Remove the screw and pry the cover off the circuit board with a screwdriver. Try spraying each electrical connection with a contact cleaner like Deoxit, or clean each connection with sandpaper or steel wool. Spray it with contact cleaner, coat with dielectric or bulb grease, and put it back on. Crimp any that are loose with pliers, look for damaged wires, and check the fuses. If the flame lights, but after about 30 seconds the solenoid closes and the flame goes out, your flame sensor, known as a thermocouple, may be bad. This probe tells if the flame is lit and shuts off the propane if the flame goes out. If cleaning the electrical connections doesn't fix it, test or replace the thermocouple. If there's debris on the thermocouple that glows yellow in the flame and you see sparks, that can be a sign the burner tube or the flue needs cleaning. Let it cool and you can clean the thermocouple with a toothbrush, wire brush, or steel wool. Unplug and remove the spark igniter, then remove the burner tube to clean it. I had to loosen the thermocouple and bend it aside to get the mounting screw out. Take the burner tube out and clean the inside with a bottle brush and the outside with steel wool, and blow it out with compressed air. If you get sparks but no flame, somehow the propane is not getting through. The gas from the jet should blow a strip of paper like this when the fridge is running on propane. If it doesn't, Unscrew the brass jet and gently clean it with alcohol and compressed air. If you don't hear the solenoid valve open like this, tap on the solenoid and clean the connections. You can test your gas pressure with a do-it-yourself manometer by attaching a tube with colored water in it to the test port, then turn on the fridge. It should be about 11 inches between the low and high. This one was 12 inches, but dropped to 11.5 when I lit the stove too. Turn the dial on the regulator to adjust it. If it's below 10 inches, it may not burn as clean and can soot up the flue. If the electrical components still aren't working, you may need a new circuit board. They can go bad. Turn on the fridge on gas, push on different parts, and wiggle the wires. I pushed on this black box and suddenly the flame lit. It should light without me doing that. Be sure to get the right circuit board for your model and follow the directions. The replacement may look slightly different than the original. Disconnect the power, unhook each wire from the old one, take the board out, put the new one in, and connect each wire to the spot labeled for it. I found it was fairly easy to do and now it works great. If your controls aren't working, you may need a new eyebrow. Absorption fridges work best in weather between 32 and 100 degrees Fahrenheit. If it's below freezing, block the air vent some. If it's hotter, park in the shade and run a fan over the coils on the back side. Running a fan inside the fridge helps distribute the cold more evenly. Since propane fridges are slow to cool, we put ice in both the freezer and the fridge and fill it with cold food. Lo thermometers with remote sensors show the inside temperatures without having to open the doors. If your fridge gets too cold and freezes your food, your control panel or circuit board may have an adjuster. Also, try sliding the thermistor down where it will be colder. It's a sensor on the cooling fins that tells the fridge when to stop cooling. If the fridge runs constantly and is always too cold, replace it. To do that, find and unplug the old thermistor wire from the circuit board, cut off the connector, tape the new sensor to the old wire really well, taping lengthwise to make it smooth, and pull it through from inside the refrigerator. The hard part is getting that taped section to bend through the hole. That may take some wiggling, poking, and pulling. Then mount the new sensor in the fridge, plug the new connector into the circuit board, and test it to make sure it's working right. If the drain reservoir is empty, pour some water in it to prevent outside air from being sucked into the fridge. Clean up any debris like soot, leaves, spider, or bird nests that could be a fire hazard. If you need to clean the flue baffle, it's accessed from the top vent, which has a screen you have to remove or cut to access the baffle wire. I'm not an RV mechanic, but my fridge didn't work and I fixed it, and you can too.